deep in me that I knew that actually I have a freedom as an artist to do whatever I want. I have a freedom as an artist to make art out of dust if I want. I mean, Manzoni made this beautiful piece, Artist Breath, which he just actually blow his air into the balloon, and that was work. So, you know, and it's as just air. So I had that freedom, and that was almost overpowering me. I was like a drunk from that strong, you know, emotion.
First of all, the life of Piero was not so easy in the way to produce his work, because nobody believed in what he was doing, you know, and the family first. only the friend, the artist friend, they understand and they believe in Piero. But otherwise, it was very difficult. Nobody was looking. And when he was invited here in Herning, it was the first time in which somebody leave him to be free to do what he liked to do, you know. The Socle du Monde has this fantastic, intelligent, and very, very humor, very cultural, very a big idea around everything. So for me, it's one of the best work of all the Piero production. He broke completely what everybody believed the art was.
Piero Manzoni. He did some brilliant things, particularly these, like, not endless, but these drawings, this kind of on paper, that are, well, I guess were made mainly in Denmark. I just like that idea that you just have to accept that the drawing's there because you can't see it. It's like enclosed inside the paper. I think he was important because it seemed to be not so much about the art, but more about this idea of performance, that all of the work, be it him standing next to this massive spinning wheel of paper in some kind of newspaper printers or a paper maker in Denmark, or him signing a naked girl, or him blowing up a balloon, all of these things were just about the performance and not about so much about the product. It was about the involvement in the production of work. You don't really need to have a product, you just need to have the end product of doing something else. You don't necessarily, it's the making of the work that's important and not necessarily the work.
He did many different things, so that's always a guarantee. If you want to remain interesting for the next generations, you basically should have a very complex oeuvre, an oeuvre with lots of layers, lots of possible meanings, and people can get very obsessive about artists with an oeuvre like that. It's not just an inspiration, but also a legitimation, just because he has been doing canned shit a long time ago, it legitimizes all our activities, it legitimizes my activities. It's more like a legitimation than an inspiration.
I think the way Manzoni approached always to view something completely upside down and completely different perspective than existing ones is in a way always the artist's task. However, there are not so many artists who achieve this. His piece always gives us question, bringing us to the center to replace and reposition ourselves in the world.
I think, you know, where right now we live in this topsy-turvy world that where everything is upside down, where governments are run by people that might necessarily be fit for running government. And this just shows that at any point in time, things can go back to horrific stages of life in the past, that there's no, of course, things are getting better, but sometimes we're on this this roller coaster ride, and this structure, this box, this sculpture, the Socle du Monde, is meant to remind us that everything is not perfect, and we need to turn things upside down and look to artists for some answers.
You know, he manages to concentrate. He concentrates and puts into a kind of very, very simple form what he sees as being his solution to the problem of art. And, you know, I think his work is absolutely amazing. I mean, it's extraordinary. I mean, it is extreme in many ways. I mean, he, you know, I mean, this idea of, like, taking your own shit and canning it, you know, and making little labels for it, I mean, you can't really beat that. I mean, it's extraordinary. I mean, he gets to the sort of like the logical kind of conclusion of thought in terms of like production and the way to kind of invert a hierarchy. And I mean, he's a massive inspiration for me. I mean, you know, he's definitely one of the artists who kind of really, you know, has, you know, struck a kind of, and just, and actually, like, it's, I think it's fun. I mean, I think it's, you know, it's profound and simple.